in anything is not illegal.
And that's a question for.
I wanna take a look at this.
Well, we still have the same situation. Yeah, we could say you got to move it over by how many feet. But we still haven't addressed the core problem that we're fixing to have with, what, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 more of these in the next couple of months. We can specify you got to move it how many feet off the property line, because that is within our power or purview as the zoning board of.
Can we say it has to be enclosed?
I think we can say that.
Ms. Jackson?
Yes.
Can we specify it has to be removed, moved over from the property line and also with walls and a door?
You can ask, you can condition with whatever you need by. Yes, yes.
I got a quick comment. So the other one, it seemed like we approved because it was more aesthetically pleasing and kind of mirrored the design and aesthetics of.
And a super narrow lot.
Of the house, of the existing house.
Super narrow lot.
So could we condition this to, you know, be designed in a style more similar to that, the house? Is this perfect?
Yes.
Ready for motion? No more questions for staff? Thank you. Would someone like to make a motion?
Make a motion to approve with certain stipulations that it has to be moved 20 feet from the property line. And that it has to have walls.
Minimum 20 feet.
Minimum 20 feet. It has to have walls and doors.
Landscaping?
It's going to have to have walls and doors and 20 feet from the property, at least 20 feet.
Right.
Siding.
I'm sorry, what was that site?
D.
Criteria D.
What about material of construction? I mean, I think it's okay to just.
Do you want to put in keeping of design?
Yeah, I like to keep them installed.
And then keep it.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Is that the last caveat to the motion? Is there a second to the motion?
A second.
All those in favor? All those opposed? Okay, it was unanimous. Thank you very much.
Ma'am?
Yes.
I know this is probably silly, but when you said 20 feet from the property line, you meant side.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We'll move on to the next case. VAR 2019-08, Grace Baptist Church of South Georgia, 6749 U.S. Highway 84. Can I see what we're going to do on the next case?
Sir?
Yes. After the meeting or tomorrow, you can consult with staff.
Yes, sorry, thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This is application VAR-2019-08.
variance to section 4.07.04 of the UOPC as it pertains to general landscape standards and table 4.07.06C as it pertains to buffer area standards. The subject property is located at 6749 US Highway 84 East, New Georgia, and at EA State Agricultural Zoning District, and consists of 4.228. Grace Baptist Church is seeking relief to the general landscape requirements and the buffer area standards in their entirety. It is the church intent to utilize the existing trees and vegetation on the lot.
Thank you.
The church property is surrounded by agricultural zoning districts, which will require a minimum buffer width of 20 feet. 0.42 acres or 18,000 plus square feet of ground cover will be required. The west lot line will require a minimum of 16 trees and 100 shrubs. The north lot line will require 21 trees and 134 shrubs. And lastly, the east lot line will require 16 trees and 100 shrubs. Per the applicants, it will be financially difficult for the church to meet the UOPC's landscaping and buffering regulations at this time. Thus, the applicants are seeking relief in its entirety through the various process to vote section 4.07.04 and table 4.07.06C as it pertains to the minimum landscape standards and the minimum required buffers.
Okay, questions for staff?
Can you describe to me what it is that we're talking about when we're talking about a buffer? Different from a setback?
Say that again.
Is it different from the setback?
Yes, ma'am. Setback, that's just the distance your structure needs to be from the actual property. That's setback. The buffer is purposed to be a,
It's a landscape area.
I can't think of the word that I'm looking for, but the purpose of the buffer is to separate. They all have various width depending on the use versus the adjacent property owner's zoning. That will determine the use of the property and the zoning will determine how wide the buffer has to be. The buffer is created from the exterior property line inward. In this case, that would be from our property line in, I believe I said, 20 feet. Okay. So we would have a 20 feet width in there. The buffer says that for every 100 linear feet of a property line, for every 100 linear feet, I need to plant them 4 trees and 25 shrubs.
In that 20 feet?
Yes, ma'am. That's
okay.
The guideline.
Okay, and they can use what's existing. So if there were, you know, 6 ginormous trees, we might count them or something.
Yes.
And it could or could be like a park-like area where they're just not going to have the parking lot run right up to the edge of the property because that's not buffer. So the parking lot's not going to be over there. It's going to be a park-like area around the edge of their property to shield their neighbors.
Yes, yes, yes. That's what we're going to do.
Buffer, again, here I am jumping out again.
Yeah, please.
The buffer is designed to screen from view and to muffle sound. The way I was told years and years ago.
Well, here's my question about this. Right now, they're up against the PA. And so we might say, well, those trees behind them or the cotton field next door doesn't care if they're buffering. But in the future, those properties might change hands and have different views and they might become residential. And then
when we said that this piece of property no longer needs to have any buffering, and they're right up to the edge. So that might be a problem for the future. This is the sort of my question.
I see where you're going with that, Ms. Redden. This scenario, and yes, ma'am, you're right on every point. But I do want to say this on behalf of Pastor Frazier and the church. I do believe in speaking, after speaking with Pastor Frazier, that it is the church intent, ma'am, to at some point be able to add possible vegetation and things of that nature to beautify the land. It's just that at this point right now, they're just saying that it's not feasible for the church to adhere to what the UODC is requiring of them.
Have y'all recommended approval in some time that they don't have to do anything?
Yes, I presented this to our TRC staff. We usually will meet. I usually have at least two or three meetings in there, ma'am, that I can. Everybody sure? Anybody got any changes and afterthoughts? Initially, when this was mentioned, nobody had any negative comments.
Is it the fact that this is a church that's triggering the buffer requirement? I mean, if it was going to be a residence, would there be a buffer requirement?
No, so if it was going to be a residence against a residence, no, there's no separation.
It's a church against EA zoning.
Right.
And are they requesting, is their request that they put no vegetation up?
Well, and I talked to, as you can see, so there are some trees on site. The part that, for the most part, I believe the pastor explained to me would be some type of fresh rock or milling, something to that effect. And outside of that, what is on site, that is what it is. Basically.
It just seems like quite a variance request, because if you look at the ULDC requirements, it's a lot. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's a lot.
May I answer something on that as well, Nathan? Now, in talking with Pastor Frazier, professional Mr. Rodney Terry, Rodney mentioned the fact that I would really like for the board to, you know, consider the fact, I really wish I had a better picture for that west lot line for you all, and I apologize for that, but Rodney's thing was, consider the fact that we've actually constructed the building so many hundreds of feet off that west property line, and in the north, I think they just simply meet what the setback actually is, but that thing is 20, and it could be more, I'm not sure on that. So, and then, of course, you do have that continuation of that very tree line on that east line.
Is that on adjoining property or on the subject property?
No, so the trees in the back, that's your north line. That is on the church's property.
Yes,
a portion of it.
Yes, a portion of it.
Yes.
The north line as it is, with the exception of shrubs, would meet the ULD standards as it is now. It just would be lacking the shrubbery on that north border. I mean, there are things now, there are little saplings and whatnot that actually, is, if it's a screen that you're looking for, we've got the screen on our property as is now, but it's not necessarily a shrub per type as the ULDC might require. And I'm sorry, I may have spoke better term.
That's fine. Any more questions for staff? Okay. Would the applicant or the applicant's representation like to come forward?
Yes, and I'm Mike Frazier, the pastor of the church of 107 Madison Highway, Valencia. In addition to the letter that we submitted with the request for relief, in light of the fact that we are a church, has been mentioned, which is, we fall into, I guess, somewhat of a commercial category, but not yet a typical commercial category. As Ms. Deborah said, the code would require any kind of residential screening, residence to residence. And, we're only going to be there a couple, few hours a week, even in contrast to what a residence would be there. We're not going to require, I think, in some ways, the amount of screening that another would even. And like the fact as well, you know, the address that we're at, we're way up on the easternmost part of the county in a very rural area. As Ms. Deborah said, our eastern borderline now has, I think what would be looked upon as an ample buffer, but it's not quite at places 20 foot wide, and it might not have the shrubbery that DC calls for. The one thing in question, the western border, we don't really have anything along that western border other than a good amount of distance, as Ms. Deborah talked about. And as the church, we kind of like the idea, and our neighbor does as well, of having that where he can visually see our church. We've had a lot of thefts at Naylor, even across the county line in Stockton, and we're not going to be there twice a week. And our neighbor, Mr. Brandt, he can at least keep some eyes on what we got going on. And the distance itself, I think, provides for him his satisfaction at the hires that we're going to have. We're not involved with one another. And from a, yes, ma'am.
Go ahead.
Okay. And just one further thing I want to say with regard to the shrubs. You know, we not only have an initial cost that at this time is, you know, something that could be problematic for us, but we're looking to try to be as low maintenance as we can as a church. We work all our maintenance stuff done, you know, by our members. And it's a lot easier, of course, to get out there on lawnmower, just mow the grass and go home. Eventually, bushes, you had mentioned a park, you know, that's nice to have a park. And then, you know, the border of Lanier County, but we really don't have resources to upkeep the park properly. That would take a little time. Bushes need to be trimmed, they need to be cleaned up. There are places for snakes to hide, and we don't need that. You know, if we can just grass everything, we keep it mowed. And the last thing, before you guys have any questions for me, is just, you know, I can give you assurance within reason that, you know, we want to make our facilities attractive. That makes common sense for us as a church, and I give you my word that we're not going to have something that's going to be unattractive. You know, I can't tell you exactly what that's going to look like, and it'll probably change during the process of time. But we give you our word that that's our hope to do that, and we want to busy ourselves with not being bondage to keeping up building the ground. We've got things that we pray would be more fruitful for our community, locally and in the larger area. So that's. We appreciate your consideration of our case.
What kind of time frame would you anticipate that it would take you to get everything dressed up like this?
Well, you know, we'll probably initially dress up just a little bit, you know, the front of our church. We would anticipate putting some potted plants on the front, you know, to make it look nice. But again, really, our hope is with bushes and all those kind of things, and as I mentioned, our Easter border with Mr. Graham, we really, if we would be allowed, would rather just keep it pretty much as is, cleaned up, mowed grass, and, you know, something more of a low maintenance. And that would be our hope. Again, we would do what we have to do, but it's our hope that we'd be allowed to kind of make the place attractive and aesthetic, you know, based on what we feel like is aesthetic.
There's no intent to remove any of the existing vegetation that's there?
As far as the trees, no, not any of the large trees. Now, we might clean up, we've got a little bit of cleanup to do as far as some of the smaller stuff on the border that's just, I mean, it's just ugly. It's not a shrub or a tree, it's just something in between. But we don't plan at all to do anything. And as I say, you know, I went through the county, you would look at the northern and the eastern border, and they're pretty close to meeting the UNLV standard now. Just there are certain places where we don't have a full 20 foot.
I have a lot of things to say. Sorry. It's not so much my concern about what we'll do. Well, if we grant a variance to this piece of property, it stays with the piece of property and this building. To say that there needs to be no buffer between this property and neighbor's property in perpetuity is a problem. Because your property might change hands and be something else, and then that owner wouldn't have to make a build, do whatever, right up to the edge of it. And I'm not good with that because we have neighbors. We need to be good neighbors. It seems like the property has quite a lot of trees already on it. And if under those trees you
option for 20 feet from the property line, then you might be able to call it good and say you have some nice trees there, maybe not 4 per 100 foot, but some of those trees are pretty big and they're nice and you don't need to have 4 per 100 foot. And then along the side with your neighbor who's going to be your on-site security kind of guy, which somebody's going to have security.
Yes, ma'am.
Some trees can be planted such that they offer some nice buffering, and you can still see through them, say, 3 or 4 rows of pine trees. You can still easily see through them, they grow tall, they make a lovely buffer, they don't cost that much. I'm good with skipping over that.
Yeah, another comment. In years past, we have conditions, variances for this particular use.
I know we have, but it's hard for, our planning and zoning is already short staff, it's hard for them to keep up with this stuff.
Randy.
Are there any other questions for the applicant? Thank you, sir. Is there anybody else here in support of this case? Do you wish to speak or just be recognized as in support?
Well, I actually am a member of that, and I have to take care of it, but on the east side, the guy does have a bunch of buildings there because he's got, he works out of his house. Mr. Grant, actually, he's been a lot of help because he's one of the sources of property. There is, on the backside, home side, you can see there is a big bumper. And also, we can buy the island on half of the river. So, I don't really, matter of fact, the county just built a boat ramp down there. So, I don't see no homes being after they are, but we have to put them on floats. But we appreciate y'all's time.
Can we get your name and address for the record, please?
Okay, my name is Dan Brickman. I live in Stockton, Georgia, 15 Pine Circle.
Thanks, sir.
Thank you.
Anybody else here in support of the case? Anybody here in opposition to the case? Ms. Deborah, was there any contact to your office?
Yes.
Okay. Any more questions for staff or anyone? No? Anybody like to make a motion?
I make a motion that we grant the variance on general landscape requirements, that they don't have to do any shrubbers. And that they have 10 years to plant the trees. And that they not get a variance on the buffer.
D. Do we have a second?
I'll second one.
All those in favor? All those in opposition? 4 in favor, 1 in opposition. Thank you very much. Variance passes. We will move on to the Valaska cases. APP 2019-03, Pete's Auto Shop, 401 East Penn Street.
And an exception.
plan shows the existing building, proposed building, and the parking across the street. He is asking for two variances. First is the setback, front yard setback variance for the new building. This lot is a little bit of an unusual circumstance in terms of the front setback. The front yard is technically considered Marion Street rather than Ann. You think Ann would be above the four rows. In this circumstance, the longest street frontage wins, so to speak, in terms of front yards. So that makes Marion this front yard in terms of setback variances. So for Hollywood Commercial, it'd be required 25 feet for front yard setbacks. He is requesting it to be flush even with his existing building and requesting a variance to allow it to be 9 feet away from the right. The second variance he's asking for is for parking across the street. Ordinarily, shared parking is required to be, parking is required to be either on the lot that it's, the development's occurring on, or shared on a lot that is immediately adjacent, touching that particular lot. In this circumstance, he owns property across the street. Crossing the street requires a variance. He meets parking regulations except for if you cross the street. So staff reviewed it, is recommending approval with six conditions. I agree that's correct, that is correct. First, the new building shall be no closer than 9 feet from the street driveway line. The new front wall being in line with the front wall of the adjacent existing building and on the smooth siding. Two, there shall be a minimum 8 foot tall brick solid fence erected around the newly established front yard setback line, connecting the corners of the two buildings, and also extending southward to the new building to the southern parking lot. Third, the east wall of the new building shall be facaded with an attractive durable material in accordance with the requirements of LDR section 214-7, with both buildings painted a matching color. Four, there shall be no driveways or particular access to the main parcel from Marion Street. Five, the street yard area between the fence and building and the western Marion Street driveway line shall be landscaped with heavy evergreen vegetation to greatly obscure the fence and building walls as approved by the city ordinance. And lastly, number six, the existing small shed in the interior of the main parcel shall obtain any applicable permits and necessary inspections as a part of the plan review and permitting for the new development. Staff recommends approval of those conditions. Any questions?
Can you help me understand recommendation number two?
Okay. We are recommending a 8 foot tall egg solid fence along the newly established front yard setback.
From the corner of the building to the, okay, to the property line.
If Ann Street were the front yard, how many of these would we need? How much of this would we need?
You would still need, you actually need both. In Highway Commercial, that Marion Street would be considered a side yard. Side yard facing the street is 15 feet. He's proposing that. So you still need a variance of 6 feet.
Okay.
And you still need the parking variance.
Okay, but it would be less over.
Yes, ma'am.
If we did what was sensible.
And I understand the part.
Okay.
Yes.
On number two, about the fence. Why have y'all requested a fence on the Marion Street side as opposed to the side, the west side of his property? Because when you ride Ashley Street, it will be visible from Ashley.
I understand your concerns.
So I don't know why y'all requested a fence on the Marion Street side.
Because of the residence is across the street.
Have you looked at
them?
I mean, when I came by there today, $2 were hanging off.
So you might live there in the future.
No, I don't blame the residents. I blame the property owners.
I understand.
That's who I blame. So I'm wondering, who this fence is for, because there are a lot of people that go up and down Ashley Street. Whereas, doesn't seem to be a lot of pride on Marion Street.
It is totally at the board's discretion whether to offer or amend the gate fully.
It is in the code when you have two dissimilar side by side and the road doesn't count. That's why it says that you have to do that. The reason you'll have to do it on the west side of the Ashley Street side is you've got the same classification, same usage. Of course, it doesn't keep you. I understand the extent of what you're saying, but that's why it's not.
And we can do anything.
For you to vote, as long as it's not illegal and reasonable.
Any other questions of staff? Thank you. Would the applicant or the applicant's representation like to address the board?
My name is Matt Phelps. My address is 4560F Belmont Drive. I'm the owner's engineer for the project. Couple things, just that Tracy, I don't think mentioned earlier, is that the piece across the street we're asking for the parking variance is already owned by Mr. Ferrari. It's just across the street versus touching directly next door. And you're back to Gretchen, your point about, well, in the future, being nice house sitting there in a few years, who knows? So kind of back to that same argument, it kind of applies here also. But the buffering, I'll already say the buffering between similar zonings is just not required. That's something the board's going to insist on. I would just simply request to amend, because that would be something that is entirely above and beyond what's required in any way in the code. So, but other than that, if there's any other concerns or questions,
first question I'd like to ask, parking across the street, is that going to be for employee parking, for customer parking?
It would be for.
Is the any intent that there will be vehicles over there that are in process of being repaired?
No, sir, that's primarily going to be employee parking. This is the, to clear out the home property around the building for customers in the front as they're dropping off, you know, vehicles, and anything that's in process would either be kept in the shop or behind it on the front.
The vehicles that are over on that private, on that across the street parcel now, are they Pete's vehicles or are they?
Probably half and half.
Half and half.
Some are there on the day for employee use, and the other half is customer vehicles.
So there could be some customer vehicles as they're related to come into work on the park there.
Well, the reason for the question is at least one vehicle parking over there now that looks like it's borderline derelict. Didn't know whether this was going to be some additional storage of vehicle that he's using for parts vehicle or something like that.
So sad. We'll do a better job of keeping that area clean. There's 87 cars there today, and trying to get a bigger building so we can move the cars out quicker. Obviously, Nancy was there today. With a bigger building, I can hire more help and get the cars out quicker. But probably the vehicle you're thinking about is a Land Rover Discovery. It's in line to be worked on. It's rough, but it's his.
Well, I just, when I went by, I looked at it, the windows rolled down, and the rain going out right there, and squirrels are building nesting.
He wants it fixed.
And I don't want it to become a spot to park vehicles as you're robbing parts off of them to fix others, because I saw at least one other Discovery that that, and you know, I'm guilty of that some degree in my business, because I'll take two or three of the same thing that I got, and one dies, and I'm scavenging parts off of it to build,
yes, sir,
keep this one going.
We're trying to make the place more efficient, have more employees, and get people out, get cars out, you know, get them fixed and move them on. Thank you.
Tracy, on these requirements for this vegetation, when they came up with so many trees and so many shrubs and all this, was that figured upon instant today privacy? Or was it calculated based on down the road? Because generally, and I'm a gardener, I plant all the time, I create a monster plants. Generally, it takes 3 years for everything to just take off.
And that was the
do a,
that was the intent. Not to provide today's screening, but for them to have a good enough start that they would.
Okay, that's what I wanted to know. Because sometimes you can plant so much stuff, especially these Leyland cypress that everybody went crazy with, and you don't have any land left. I mean, they just, you almost have to move because they take up. So that's one of my concerns, because there's limited land, but if you've got a fence and you're also requiring a buffer, I mean a plant buffer.
So in this situation, the plant address is on the outside of the fence, between the fence and the street. We are going to have to meet some land portions of landscaping ordinance for front yard, side yards, and rear for the ashes inside. So there will be some vegetation planted along that line somewhere.
On the western line?
Yes.
So that you won't be able to?
I can't say that would be a visual barrier, but there'll be something.
Yeah. You'd be looking at the trees and not be looking at the rest of the plants.
I want to go back to parking for a second. Tracy, could we make a requirement that they would not be overnight parking?
Yes, it'd be hard for staff to monitor the issue then.
Okay, but you know, somebody that rides by and there's some parked in there, can we take it?
Overnight parking, one.
And there's a parking lot across the street.
That's the problem there.
Any other questions for the applicant's representation? Thank you. Anybody else here that would like to speak in support of the case? Anybody here that would like to speak in opposition to the case? Tracy, was there any contact in your office? Okay. Are there any other questions from the board? No questions? Somebody would like to make a motion?
I make a motion to approve the variance as requested with six conditions and the seventh condition that there be no overnight parking in the parking lot.
Second. Oh.
Siding criteria.
Because it meets all, this is different. Because it meets all of the.
Yes, you're correct, sorry. We have a second. All those in favor? It is unanimous. Thank you. All right, second K, Palasta case, AEP 2019-04, Ian McTurk.
Garage size was capped at 900 square feet.
walks 1,200 square feet, 300 square feet more. So therefore, that's why he's asking for variance. He can make side of the setbacks, he can make rear setbacks, he can be distances from the house, there's no technical issues there. It's purely a size issue. Staff reviewed it, voted upon hardship, and recommended denial.
Any questions for staff? None? Thank you. Would the applicant or the applicant's representation wish to address the board?
Since this is Ridge Road, basically, 30 by 30 would not allow me to park my boat all the way in there. 24-foot boat and get motor and trailer. Basically, I'm only requesting distance from your, basically your desk to that wall distance. No, that would be 30 on the front and 40 that way. I have three letters from my neighbors, if I can give you them.
Sure.
Have no problem with what I want to do. One on each side and one on.
Okay. Any questions for the applicant?
You could by right attach this to your house. Is there some reason not to do that?
Like, it's too far back from an actual house. The house, and then there's a screening pool, and then there's no way I can meet the setbacks if I did attach it. They have that long skinny wall.
All right, tell me again, I know the size 30 by 40. 30 feet wide, 40 feet deep, and that's because of the boat.
How tall is the building? It's going to be 14 feet to the soffit.
I'm sorry, I think it's probably, we changed it to 12 feet, but his door should be 10 foot. So 12 foot each one?
Yes.
Planning on building it out of?
Brick that would match my house on the bottom, and then stuck it outside, and drop it outside, and then same shingles.
Stick built or red iron?
What?
Stick built or red iron?
Stick built.
Is it a metal building, or is it a wood building? Any other questions for the applicant? Thank you, sir. Anybody else here in support for the application?
My name is Trevor Shaw, from 3525 Lake Road. I'm the contractor that would help Ian build this. I think Tracy stated, there's nothing aesthetically that's an issue. There's only a setback issues here. It's only the fact that we're asking for a little more. I'll say if it was a hardship, it would be because he could not get his boat, tip his trailer to the end of his motor in a 30-foot section. So I bought the tape, I think it was 30 by 10, to give you some feel of what that would be like. But it's not, we're asking, we're going to make it wider. And also, the building really is not even seen from the street because of the vegetation, the trees are out there. Approximately probably 50 feet behind his house is where this would be set. And he did have the adjoining owners and the one in the back that were left for his back. Wood frame totally to look like his house, matching shingles, brick would be the same on the bottom. So that's not the issue.
Okay, those questions. It's going to be on a concrete slab?
Yes, ma'am.
Is there going to be any water?
No.
Any other questions for support? Thank you, sir.
Now, you're saying like water pipe for bathroom or something like that?
Thank you, sir. Anybody else here in support of the case? Anyone here in opposition to the case? Is there any contact to your office? Any other questions from the board? No? Anybody like to make a motion?
I'm making a motion to approve this request.
Any seconds?
Second.
Second. All those in favor? All those opposed? Four in favor, one opposed. Thank you, sir. All right, we'll move on to the next case, APP 2019-05, Adam Moore with Armor Investments.
Your next case is a property lot on 2704 North Head Street, building B1. It is specifically for Hunter's Farms. They are requesting a couple of variances to one to impervious surface, one rear yard setbacks. They are proposing to build an approximate 7.5 feet in width and 34 feet long variance on the rear of the building to accommodate some additional compounding area as required in federal regulations. There's not a whole lot of room back there between the existing wall and the existing property line. So their intent is to buy some property along the rear of the property from their adjacent property, from the adjacent property owner, and build on the additional land and floor space. They are requesting a variance to allow their new building, the new addition, to be 4 feet from the property line. RP rear yard setback is 25 feet, so there's a substantial variance request. The second variance request is impervious space. RP requires 60% impervious surface. They are increasing their impervious surface from 76.1% to 79.6%. So that's a slight increase. So two variance requests, impervious surface, rear yard setback. Staff understands that it is federal regulation that is triggering these, but could find no hardship beyond design's control and recommend for none.
Any questions for staff? Thank you. Is Adam here and after the presentation here, like to address the board?
I'm Adam Moore, address 952 Craig Road. I am a pharmacist and owner of Veterans Pharmacy. And just quick background on my compound is, if you don't know, the traditional prescription when you get it filled, it's commercially available, say Crestor, 20 milligrams. We buy it from a wholesaler, they sell on a shelf, we get a prescription, we fill it. For prescription or medications that are not commercially available, that's where compounding comes in. Say amoxicillin, 320 milligrams is what the dose is needed. It's not commercially available. We can then compound that using bulk ingredients and make it to the desired dosage form, whether it be a capsule, liquid, you know, whatever. So what we're doing is we're meeting specific needs for a specific patient. So just jump back on the compound. So that being said, these new regulations, handling the USP, OSHA, they all have these lists of hazardous drugs, and a lot of what we deal with falls under that category. So when you moving forward with these new regulations, you have to have two separate labs, one that handles hazardous material and one that's non-hazardous. So where we used to be able to operate in one room, now we have to have two, and we are kind of limited on the space where we are. Our neighbors to the rear, used to be Dr. Howard's dermatology practice. He sold that to Dorothy and Billy Steinberg. Dorothy is a speech pathologist, and she has that building and the one to our south, so she operates that too. I went to them first before I ever filed an application to see if they were willing to, you know, let me have that little bit of area. And we, this is the actual, this part has got the measurements, is what our proposed addition is to that. So the when we initially started talking, we we had an initial sketch, Billy wanted to see kind of what it would look like, what I was proposing, so we did a sketch, set some flags. He wasn't quite comfortable with that, so then I adjusted that, and so that's what you see now is the adjusted one. And I reached out to Billy to try to get a letter, but he maybe I never heard from him Friday, but I did have an email, you know, where we were going back and forth where this is, I don't know if you got one. So this is where I sent him the attachment, is the image you see, and then he said, okay, he was, his building is financed by Dr. Howard, so he wanted to run it by Dr. Howard also to make sure he was okay. Dr. Howard came, he's a customer of ours, so I approached him, asked him, he said, yes, he's fine with it. So then, in another email chain, this is where I spoke to Dr. Howard. Daniel Shirt is a lawyer who is representing me. He contacted Billy, so there's a little bit of just a verification that Dr. Howard was approached about it and gave his consent. In the packet that I guess I was sent, there was a Mr. Bergstrom who had concerns about removal of trees, and we will not have to remove any canopy trees.
Any questions for the applicant?
I've got a question. What year did y'all buy that building?
We bought the building 2 years ago, 2017. I bought the business in 2014.
Okay, when you bought that building, I know y'all did major remodeling. Had this law come out, this federal law?
The law came out, the way USP works, they're not a non-governmental organization, so they set standards, they give recommendations, and it's up to pretty much each state whether they adopt them. So Georgia, the State Board of Pharmacy, does adopt, and they're going to follow those. So it came out probably about 3 years ago, they initially came out with, there's a almost like a debate period where you can give input, and they can kind of tweak the recommendations. So then they finally set the hard deadline to be going into effect for December of this year is when it goes into effect, and the State Board of Pharmacy can then enforce it, and their arm of enforcement is the Georgia Drug and Narcotic Agency, so they have field reps that, you know, inspect us.
So you had basically done all your remodeling and all that, and this came down the pipe?
Well, we did the remodeling. We had a firm out of North Carolina that specialized in pharmacy design, so we initially approached the issue then. At the time, there was so much tweaking to the regulations, and it was not sure as to whether or not Georgia was going to adopt, you know, and enforce that. So, this firm dealt with many states, so he said South Carolina does not recognize USP guidelines, and so he said, wait, see what Georgia does before we do anything. And so when Georgia finally accepted it towards the end of last year is when, you know, we began the process.
We have multiple clients are going through and having to meet this new regulation in the year's timeline. Is that one of the reasons? Sorry, I should
start. Yeah, no, I have a question about, I don't know what these, what is non-sterile HD space?
In that drawing?
Yeah.
That was the original, the...
So you have these two little rooms in the back, and that's where the special work is going to happen.
Yeah, so the existing building there, the when we redesigned the building 2 years ago, we kind of just piggybacked off that drawing. So initially they had said for us that might have been a possibility, but we packaged medications for nursing homes, and that room is where all of that takes place. So that can't be serviced. A compounding area. So where you see existing lab, in that drawing is where we're currently.
Where you're currently doing it, and you have to make, that's not big enough to do these two.
Right, because you have to have two separate rooms, and you have to have a negative air pressure for both of those rooms. This room has two entrances, and you have to be able to kind of sequester those, so you don't have passive traffic coming through just to prevent exposure to any hazardous material.
I have a question for Tracy.
Go ahead.
If he purchases some footage from his neighbor to be able to have any amount of setback, is he then encroaching his neighbor's front backyard? Is that a building on that still needing the setback?
More than likely not. And staff realizes that this most of this complex is more than likely already non-conforming.
Okay. So they already don't need the backyard setback?
Correct.
So they're just going to not need to buy more. Do you know how much they don't need to buy? I drove around and around and around those buildings today trying to figure it out.
No.
Yeah, all the Trace was developed. It's a private development.
Yeah. It was one big thing, and then it turned into little things. Right. Yeah.
And they're all non-conforming grandfathered in the farm.
Right. Well, but when they're making a substantive change, then we have to try to make it be right by everybody.
Trigger.
Yeah.
The building behind us, the way it's set, like the entry door, the way I think of it, the front is facing us, but according to Daniel Shirt, the front, meaning that the door faces kind of this way, he was saying that we're approaching on their side of their building, give it up.
And in all honesty, this lot is non-conforming in several different ways, including that there's probably no technical or official front yard, and since it doesn't have any street frontage. So more than likely, I would agree with Daniel that that is a side yard.
Any other questions happening? Thank you, sir. Is anybody else here in favor and support of the application? Is anybody here in opposition to the application? Is there any contact to your office?
The only contact was email from Dr. Bunch first.
Okay. All right. Board, have any other questions? Would someone like to make a motion?
I'll make the motion to approve the variance as requested, finding it consistent with the variance review criteria.
Do we have a second?
Second.
All those in favor? Unanimous. Thank you, sir.
Don't cut the trees down.
Thank you.
All right. APP, your next case, APP 2019-06, correct? Is that one wrong?
Yes.
Yes, Mark Gaskins. Thank you.
Your last case of the day. This case in front of you is a case for Mr. Mark Gaskins for a parcel located at 3050 James Circle on the corner of James Circle and Austin Augustine Drive. Currently contains a floor covering, common covering, floor covering. Business is currently under construction. The property is zoned highway commercial, consists of about 3/4 of an acre. This particular project has been some time in the works since the day submitted plans in 2017, zoning signed off on